In this video, we'll take a look at the demand management application. Link timecodes for these topics appear in the YouTube description for this video. The demand management application helps you capture, evaluate, prioritize, and approve business requests for implementation consideration. Ideas are collected from people throughout the organization and can be used to cultivate a culture of innovation and continuous improvement. Promising ideas are shared between IT and the business unit. Approved ideas will then become demands. It's important to ensure alignment with business goals and to deflect ideas that don't drive the business forward and promote innovation. Category reflects the type of demand that will impact the business. Projects and enhancements reflect strategic requests, whereas changes and defects reflect operational requests. Your instance should have these areas set up: fiscal calendar, stakeholder register, and demand management roles. We'll start by approving an idea to upgrade App Z submitted by Joe Employee. Now the idea is promoted to a demand. A demand flows through a series of states: draft, submitted, screening, qualified, approved, and completed. Upon approval, the demand will become a project, enhancement, change, or defect. Your governance process will determine what's required to progress through the states. Let's step our approved idea through the demand management process. The demand is currently in the draft state. Some fields are already filled in from the idea. Fill in the remaining fields to include items that help IT and business stakeholders evaluate, prioritize, and select demands. We've received requests from users to improve their experience with App Z. In addition, there's been a request by the business to increase revenue. So we'll select strategic. The upgrade requires several internal resources and funding for a new server. Based on this scope, we'll call this a project instead of an enhancement. The start and due dates we choose for this demand are also pulled into business annual planning and budget dashboards. Now we'll move on to the details section. We make our selections based on the company's governance and data needs. Use the info icon next to your selection if you have any questions, or point to the field title for information text. Next, fill in the other tabs as well: business case, financials, and assessment data. Now add supporting records to reflect expected capital and operational expenses. These records include resource plans, cost plans, benefit plans, and demand budget. You can also add risks and decisions related to this demand. Other videos in this series show how to create these financial plans. When we submit the demand, it moves to the submitted state. Once the demand is accepted by the demand manager, Brian Marshall, it moves to the screening state. The screening state engages the community that has an interest in the demand. Stakeholders and approvers for the demand's portfolio are automatically part of this community. You can assign an assessment to the stakeholders. The assessment lets them voice their opinions. These responses are weighted and factored into a score for the demand. The demand now automatically moves to the qualified state. In the qualified state, the demand's data is evaluated for project acceptance into a project portfolio for fiscal year planning. The demand workbench displays a bubble chart ranking demands. The initial view shows demands from all portfolios that are in the qualified state. Let's focus on the portfolio we're working with, IT Application Modernization. We can quickly see where Upgrade App Z falls relative to other demands. Point to Upgrade App Z to see the risk, value, size, and overall score. After review, the stakeholders have agreed to move forward with this demand as a project. To turn this demand into a project, first approve the demand, then create the project. The demand is now in the approved state, and work can begin on the project. But one state still remains, completed. You can choose to complete the demand when the project begins, or you can keep the demand in the approved state until the project is finished. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.